It gives you a perspective on life. It allows you to see, almost to answer the question, why are we here? What is our purpose in life?
I feel God inside me. Whenever I do something to help others, that helps me.
Catholics across our diocese and around the world are feeling good about stewardship. That's because they've made it a way of life, committing to live their life as a disciple of Christ, to give their gifts back to God, their time, their talents, their treasure, not as an obligation of faith, but in gratitude for all that God has given to them. They feel good because they're personally experiencing the joy of stewardship.
Stewardship is, in fact, the foundation of our faith. It's the underpinnings of what it means to be a Christian, a disciple of Christ, is to use your gifts of time, talent, and treasure for the benefit of all in thanksgiving to God.
Partaking in the liturgy, listening to the gospel, praying together, experiencing the communion with God and one another, that's basically where stewardship is rooted. It's Christian life. It's the call of God to all of us.
One of my favorite quotes is from the first letter of Peter, the 4th chapter, the 10th verse. You know, as each one is given a gift, we are to use that giftedness in the service of one another as good stewards of God's very grace.
That's what Jesus did. He came to be with us, to give us God's love. And when we're called to be disciples, as we are when we're stewards, we imitate Christ.
What could be more joyous than using the gifts that God's given you to know that, by golly, God has a purpose for you, that the gifts that you have can make a difference in the lives of other people?
In Stewardship, A Disciple's Response, a pastoral letter on stewardship issued by the United States Conference of Catholic Bishops, a Christian steward is defined as one who receives God's gifts gratefully, cherishes and tends to them in a responsible and accountable manner, shares them in justice and love with all, and returns them with increase to the Lord.
When one keeps that idea of stewardship as being a disciple's response, one can carry that to school, to a place of work, to recreation, to subjects that are local or national or international, and make sense out of one's place in all of that, because always, if you accept that sense that we are stewards of our gifts and of the earth and of one another, then it does remarkable things to setting right or to deepening the relationships that we have with the community.
God gives us 144 hours a week. How much time can you give back to God? Stewardship asks us to start with God first. Before you get all of the practices and schedules and events you're going to go to, say, how much can we give God this week?
Stewardship challenges us to give a greater portion of this precious gift of time back to God by investing more time in our faith, spending more time with God through increased worship and prayer will help ensure we are spiritually prepared to offer ourselves in service to others. We need to recognize the outward and even the hidden talents which God has given to each of us and determine how we can put these talents to good use to support our local parish, the greater church, the local community, and the world.
Like St. Bridget's gospel choir. They have seen that we don't have money and we have bills to pay. They have used their talents of singing. They have produced a CD to improve the life of the church.
What percentage of my income do I want to give back to God? Got a whole bunch of bills and all those kinds of things. Let's start up front and say, how much can I give back to God?
God's gift of treasure comes to us in many different ways: a hard-earned salary, a smart investment, an inheritance, even valuable personal property.
I first learned about tithing when I was younger and from my father, who was a tremendous example to our family, who started practicing tithing at a time when he was unemployed in life and trusted God for God to provide for his family.
If you really care about your church, you really care about your parish, yes, you need to donate money to it because it won't survive otherwise.
Living as a Christian steward requires that we recognize that through baptism, we each have a personal responsibility, better yet, a personal accountability to God.
First, don't be afraid. Second, have God in your heart, because God will help you. And third, I would say, be part of it. Participate with all your heart and start to do something.
A crucial part of our parish's commitment to stewardship is really connecting with our youth, to teach them and to form them and let them see by our example of people who give, people who share, people who are grateful.
By what I'm doing now with stewardship is just truly setting this example for my children. It's like creating a great foundation for them that they will always know what stewardship is.
I look at stewardship as a responsibility and gratitude, because it's a responsibility you do have to give back to your church. It's also gratitude for what God has given us and what God has done for us throughout our life.
You have to let yourself be open, and then it really is a conversion process. God, for some reason, gives you grace to be able to hear the message and say, I'm going to try just one thing. And then you try it and you really reap some of the rewards. I am becoming the person I want to be.
I know from the testimony of friends that the more you try with the grace of God to open your heart to that call, the freer you become.
Parishes across the Diocese of Rochester have established stewardship ministries to help us along this journey, to educate, communicate, motivate, and celebrate stewardship in our respective parishes.
We all want to be happy people. We all want to be joyful people. God is the one who is the giver of all those gifts. And when we return to the Lord our time, our talent, our treasure, God simply rewards us so much more than we could ever begin to imagine. That's the joy.
He will give to you pressed down, shaken together, and running over. And that's the kind of blessing and abundance that I think God wants to give us and we learn about through living a life of stewardship.
If you only have a little, you're gonna have a lot. If you give what you've got to Jesus and put it in his hands, for the Lord takes your little and uses it to make a lot from a little when you put it in his hands.